What is your sense about our time and the future hope about the decentralization of power? Do you think that's something that we can actually achieve, given that power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely, and it's so wonderful to be absolutely powerful?
Well, good question. So there are, so first of all, I believe, by the way, there is a, it's a complex question, Lex. Like all the rest of your questions. So, but,
I'm very sorry.
it's okay. I am enjoying it. So, but so there are two things. First of all, power has been centralized for a variety of reasons. When you want to get it, it's easier for somebody, even a single person, to grab power. But there is also some kind of a technology, lack thereof, that justified having in power. Because in a way, in a society in which even communication, never mind blockchain, which is common knowledge, but even simple unilateral communication is hard, it is much easier to say, you do as I say, because right, the alternative is, but as, so there is a little bit of a technology barrier, but I think that, and now to get to this common knowledge, that is a totally different story. Now we have finally the technology for doing this. So that is one part. But I really believe that, you know, not by having a distributed system, not only you don't have the, you have actually much more stable and durable system. Because not only for corruption, but even for things that go astray, and you give it a long enough time by strange version of Murphy's Law, whatever goes wrong, goes wrong. Yeah. And so, and if the power is diffused, you actually are much more stable. If you look at any living, complex living being is distributed. I mean, I don't have somebody who's okay, tell Silvio now it's time to eat. So
you have millions of cells in your body. You have billions of bacteria.
Exactly. Help me in the guts. I think, you know, we are in a soup that somehow it's keeps us alive.
It's a
pure mess. And strange enough, however, when we design systems, we design them centralized. We ourselves are distributed beings. And when we plan, say, okay, I want to create an architecture, how about I make a pyramid, I put a vest on the top, and the power flows down. And so, again, it's a little bit perhaps of a technology problem, but now the technology is there. So that is a big challenge to rethink how we want to organize power in very large system. And distributed system, in my opinion, are much more resilient. Let's put it this way. There was one of my Italian compatriots, right? You know, Machiavelli, who looked at the time, there was a bunch of a small state, democratic Republic of Florence, of Venice, and the other thing. And there was the Ottoman Empire, that at the time was an empire, and a sultan was very centralized. And he made a political observation that goes roughly to say, whenever you have such a centralized thing, it's very hard to overtake that form of government is centralized. But if you get it, it's so easy to keep the population. When instead, these other things are much more resilient. When the power is distributed, it's much more, it's going to be lasting for much longer time.
And ultimately, maybe the human spirit wants that kind of resilience, wants that kind of distribution. It's absolutely just that we didn't have technology throughout history. Machiavelli didn't have the computer, the internet, and
that is certainly part of the reason. Yes.